Good morning, 5th class children. All of you, take out your social textbooks, all of you. So, first lesson we are completed, no? So, we are writing the notes part of the first lesson. So, meanwhile, we will continue with the second lesson also. Okay? So, here what is your second lesson name is what? Okay, what is the second lesson? Reverse livelihood. Okay? Reverse livelihood. Okay? This is social lesson number 2. So, here some keywords I gave in this lesson. Okay? Reverse livelihood lesson, okay? So keywords, what are the keywords we learn first? Okay, livelihood, okay, living or profession. What is livelihood means? What? Living or profession. Okay, industries. Industries means what? A place where things are produced on a large scale. So industries is means what? We are producing large in a large quantity. Okay, that is a place. Okay, and migration. Okay, leaving one place or country and settling in other place. Okay, migration means what? Some village people come to the town. Okay, our city. For what purpose? For earning purpose, for food purpose they will come. Okay, that is nothing but migration. Okay, or going to some other country also. Okay, some Indian people go to the states, no, other countries, no, that is also a migration. Okay, so next, delta means the area between the two tributaries of a river before it joins a sea or a ocean. Okay, delta means water. Okay, the area between the two tributaries. Okay, first going to the tributaries means what? Big streams which join a river. Tributaries means what? Big streams which join a river. Okay, that is a tributaries. So here the area between the two tributaries, okay, two tributaries of a river before it joins a sea or a ocean. Before joining to a sea or ocean, two tributaries which joins at a place, that is a delta. Okay, next to tourist. Tourist means what? Okay, one second children. So here tourist means what? People who come to visit. Tourist means what? People who come to visit any place. Okay, drought means what? Dryness due to lack of rain, lack of water. So dryness, dry in the land. For water, because of the, okay, lack of rains and water. Water, from where we will get water? From rains only, no? So because of the lack of the rains, there is a drought you face. Okay, floods, overflow of water due to heavy rains. Floods means water, overflow of the water due to heavy rains. Okay, varadalu antaru kada. Tributaries, big streams which join a river. I told you, na, tributaries means small, okay, it's a streams, big streams, okay, it will join a place, that is a tributary. Okay, aquatic life. Aquatic means organism living in water. Aquatic animals means the organisms or animals or insects, whatever, which live in the water. Okay, so that is tributary, this aquatic life. Okay, dams means what? Constructions built across rivers to stop water. So dams are constructed across the river to stop the water flow. That is nothing but dams. Okay, so one second, I will take your lesson. Okay children, see, take out your textbook. Okay, lesson number 2 is there. Okay, here reverse means of livelihood. Okay, so here observe the picture here children, all of you. See, here river is there. Okay, and dam is construction here. Okay, dam also construction. Okay, what do you see in this picture? Okay, what are the people in the picture doing? Have you ever seen any such river? What are the uses of rivers? Okay, and why are boats there in the river? And what do the men in the boats do? Is river a means of livelihood? How? And are there people who depend only on rivers for their livelihood? What do they do? Okay, so this is your lesson about rivers and livelihood of the people who stay near the rivers. Okay, see, first I will take with the river Godavari. I will take, see here, you might have seen many rivers and enjoyed talking, okay, taking bath in them. Okay, moreover, if it is summer, one never wants to come out of the water, correct na? In summer, if we go to some places also, okay, Rajamandri, Pushkar also, some will be there, maybe we will go to that place, no? But don't take a dip. Okay, you might have seen many rivers and enjoyed taking baths in them. Okay, moreover, if it is summer, one never wants to come out of the water. Correct na? When we stay in the water, playing in the water in summer season, means nobody will come out from that area. Correct na? Is there any river near your place? Which river? Have you ever thought of it? Where does the river begins from? Which places does it flow through? What does it finally merge into? Where from the water comes into the river? Is water present throughout the year or does it get dry up? So, from where this river water will be coming? Okay, from where it will go? Okay, and is water present throughout the year? Okay, or does it dry up? So these are the questions we will get in our mind. Okay, do any other rivers merge into it? Okay, and will it have the same depth throughout? What is the lifestyle of the people living on the banks of the river? What is the relation they share with their river? Oops, never ending questions, but they do generate curiosity and you wish to know more about rivers, correct na? We don't know whether the river water is going to end up or it's going to dry up, where this river, throughout year we will be having that river water, and what is the lifestyle of the people who are staying across the river area. Okay, so these are the questions we will be having in our mind. Let us find out the source of river Godavari and learn about the people living on its banks. Okay, now we are taking about the Godavari river. Okay, so here, see the picture of the Godavari at Nasik. Where it is? In Nasik area. So the river Godavari originates in the hills of Brahmagiri of the Western Ghats at Trayambakeshwar in the district of Nasik in Maharashtra. In Maharashtra, Nasik district, Trayambakeshwar, Western Ghats, Brahmagiri. Okay, where it Brahmagiri hills. Okay, it enters our state at Kandakurti in Nizamabad district. So where this Ganga Godavari river meet in our state? At Kandakurti in Nizamabad district. To reach our state, it travels 1465 kilometers to meet in our place, in our state, where this Godavari meet at the place of Kandakurti of Nizamabad district. Okay, for joining there, how many kilometers it will flow? It will flow 1465 kilometers. In Telangana, it flows through the district of Nirmal. In Telangana, in which places it will flow? Nirmal, Nizamabad, Jagityal, Manchiriala, Peddapalli, Jayashankar and Bhadradri. Okay, these are the places where this Godavari river flow in our state. Once again, repeat the places. Nirmal, Nizamabad, Jagityal, Manchiriala, Peddapalli, Jayashankar and Bhadradri. Okay, it flows, separates the districts of Nirmal and Jagityal. In flowing, it separates the districts where Nirmal and Jagityala in Telangana. Where in Nirmal and Jagityala it will divide. Okay, this river divides into three parts. Okay, where how many parts? It will divide into three parts. Okay, this river divides into three parts and finally meets the Bay of Bengal. It will divide into three parts again. It will go into the same place, that is Bay of Bengal. Okay, at Antarvedi. Where? At Antarvedi. So, in East Godavari and Yanam. Okay, look at the maps of the India and Telangana in the atlas and answer the questions given below. So, you have to take the map of our Telangana state and you have to take about the river map, Godavari. Where it flows in our state. I told you some places here, no? Nizamabad, okay, Nirmal, Jagityala, Manchiryala, Peddapalli. You have to, okay, make a note of this all in your rivers map and check out where it is dividing, where this river is dividing, and it's also divided for two parts and then finally it is okay merging into the Bay of Bengal. Okay, and okay, you have to all this, you have to note it, and see, this is group work for we given for you. So check out this, check out the river map with you and Godavari river map and point out all these questions. Okay, where does Godavari starts from? Name the states through which it flows. I told you have to mark in that map. And for this you are having answer here in this paragraph only you can find the answer for this. Okay, identify the districts of Telangana through which the river Godavari flows. Just now I told you some of the districts in the Telangana this Godavari river will flow. That also you will get answer in this only. Okay, name the districts which are on the banks of the river Godavari. And like Godavari, identify river Krishna on a map of the Telangana. Even you have to mark the Krishna river in the like Godavari, identify the river Krishna on a map of Telangana. In Telangana map, you have to mark the Krishna and Godavari rivers also. Identify the cities and the holy places present on either banks of the rivers mentioned. Okay, in this Krishna or Godavari, any okay, banks are present, sir. Okay, identify the cities. Any cities are there in the place? Holy places present in the. Okay, you have to mention that also. What are the districts through which the river Krishna flows? Where? In which districts, sir? This Krishna river flow. We have to mention that also. Okay, now see the next page number 89. Okay, fisherman. 8.3 is there. Fisherman. Page number is 89. Okay, many people make a living by catching fish in Godavari. So many people, it's a livelihood for many people. By what way? By catching the fish. Okay, many people make living by catching fish in Godavari. They use boats and catch a variety of fishes, crabs, lobsters. Okay, fishing needs skill and hard work. For fishing means what? Catching fish means what? Fishing needs skill and hard work. They use different kinds of boats for fishing. They use different kinds of boats for fishing. What are they? Traditional boat, motor boat, a woman selling fishes. See, pictures are given here. Traditional boat and motor boat for her. Okay, catching the fishes they will do. And see, women are selling the fishes. See, the women kept all the fishes in front of her and selling it. Okay, the river is a source of livelihood for the fishermen. So what? River is a source of livelihood for the fishermen. Okay, now they lead their lives by fishing. By how they lead their life? By fishing. Okay, they make money for their families by catching and marketing fish. Okay, by what way they will get money? By catching the fishes from the river, they will sell it in the market and they will earn the money for their family. Okay, to catch the fish, they use both conventional boats and also motor boats. Okay, two types of boats I told you now. So, they will use both boats for the, according to the convenient. Okay, during floods, they lose the boats and their nets get damaged because of the flex time they will not do because the boats will get damaged. We are able to include nutritious fish in our diet due to the efforts of this. Okay, in our diet, okay, in our food items, we are adding fish also. It's very nutritious for us. So, okay, very, this is also a very important source of food for us, for human beings. Okay, so children, you learn the keywords today. Okay, thoroughly you learn the keywords meanings. What are this? What are tributaries means water? Okay, what are industries means water? Livelihood means water? Tourist, draft, floods. Because these are the words you will repeatedly get in this lesson. So first you have to know the meaning of that so that you can understand the lesson, children. Thank you all. For today I will complete. Okay, continue with the same lesson tomorrow, next video. Okay, have a nice day, children. Good morning.